And here is the Writer's Almanac for Monday. It's the 10th of January, 2022. It's the anniversary of the day, 1901. The first oil gusher erupted at Spindletop just outside Beaumont, Texas, the beginning of the age of petroleum. Until then, most of the oil came from Pennsylvania, and oil and petroleum were used mostly for lamps. But suddenly, with Spindletop, oil became the cheapest fuel, just about 3 cents a barrel. A man named Patillo Higgins thought there was oil there, and he enlisted a Croatian oil explorer named Anthony Lucas. They started drilling in late 1900, hit a depth of about 1,200 feet. Natural gas started shooting out of the ground, followed by crude oil. A gusher, 200 feet straight up in the air. And it was the beginning of the great Texas oil fortunes. Within the year, the town of Beaumont went from 8,000 to 60,000 people. It was on this day in 49 BC that Julius Caesar crossed the Rubicon River and launched a civil war. He had conquered most of Western Europe all the way to Britain, but back in Rome, his political alliances were falling apart. His fellow consul Pompey had turned against him, and so had the Roman Senate. The Rubicon River formed the border of the Roman Republic, and according to Roman law, if a general brought his army into the Republic from the provinces, he would be considered a traitor. And so Caesar got to the river with his army, made up his mind, said, "Alea iacta est, the die is cast," and came into the city. And crossing the Rubicon became a phrase meaning past the point of no return. It's the birthday of the historian Stephen Ambrose, born in Lovington, Illinois, 1936, son of a Navy doctor during World War II. Family followed him from post to post and then overseas. The war ended. The father came home, took up a private practice in Wisconsin. Stephen Ambrose was a pre-med student, and in his sophomore year, he took an American history class based on biographies of individuals. The professor said that the students would be completing their own biography of an unknown Wisconsinite, which they would have to use primary research from the state's historical society to write. Ambrose said, "That just hit me like a sledgehammer. It had never before occurred to me that I could add to the sum of the world's knowledge." He changed his major to history, wrote a 10-page paper on an obscure one-term Wisconsin congressman named Charles Billinghurst, and that's how his career was launched. He became the biographer of Eisenhower. Nixon wrote a best-selling book about the Lewis and Clark expedition, and he wrote around 10 books on World War II, including Citizen Soldiers and Band of Brothers. Here's a poem for today by Barbara Hamby, a sonnet from her 9 sonnets from the Psalms. "Hear my prayer, O Lord, though all I do all day is watch old black and white movies on TV. Speak to me through William Powell or Myrna Loy. Solve the mystery of my sloth. Show me the way to take a walk or catch a cold, anything but read another expose of the Kennedys. Teach me to sing, or at least play the piano. For 10 years I took lessons, and all I learned was to hate Bach. Shake me up or down, call me names, break my ears with AC/DC. I deserve far worse. Rebuke me in front of my ersatz friends. Who cares? They don't like me much anyway. Make me fat in lieu of thin. Give me a break, or don't. I'm 100 million molecules in search of an author. If that's you, thank you for my skin. Without it, I'd be in worse shape than I'm in." A sonnet by Barbara Hamby from her 9 sonnets from the Psalms in her collection All Night Lingo Tango, published by University of Pittsburgh Press, and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.